Mr. Chairman, thank you very much, Chairman Hatch and Ranking Member Feinstein. Thanks for the opportunity to be in front of your committee this morning. In the 7 years I've been a United States Senator, this is only the second time I've had the opportunity to appear on behalf of a nominee for a judgeship related to our state of Kansas, and it's a real pleasure and honor to be here in support of Holly Teeter, to have an opportunity to join my colleague from Kansas in introducing her to the committee. Her capabilities, her intellect, her character are at the highest levels in a way that this committee ought to feel very comfortable in supporting her nomination. Again, as Senator Roberts said, she graduated at the top of her class, my alma mater, the University of Kansas, where she graduated at 4.0 with highest distinctions. I love the fact that she has a degree in chemical engineering, not the necessarily the normal path to being an attorney, but demonstrating again an intellectual capability of an area of science that is very challenging. Studied at Oxford with a Rotary scholarship, and has tremendous experience as a law clerk for other judges, sure, as well as her work in the U.S. Attorney's Office. Yeah. What I wanted to say most specifically to the committee is, this is perhaps not a normal nominee that comes certainly to me as a member of the United States Senate. When her name came forward and I had the opportunity to meet with her, I'd never met Holly Teeter prior to that meeting. This is not perhaps the circumstance in which you have a political connection or a knowledge of familiarity with a nominee. It's not someone who has been on the radar screen, in my view, as the next judge from Kansas, but somebody who had a serious interest in serving in a public capacity and administering justice. The things that stand out to me is just no particular political agenda. Those of us who've experienced law school remember the days in which we were 1Ls and we had the conversation with our classmates and we discovered, oh my gosh, these people are so bright, so intelligent, they know so much, and we enjoyed the not only the camaraderie, but the intellectual challenge that comes from knowing tremendously intelligent people. And that's the kind of conversation I had with Holly Teeter, and I would readily admit, although reluctantly, I was outshone in such a dramatic way. I quit longing for my days as a 1L and determined that I had other capabilities and other responsibilities than the intellectual challenge that Holly Teeter provided me. But I also discovered character and honesty, integrity, no political agenda, a recognition of the stare decisis, a belief that that her job is to interpret the law as written, and just a sense that this will be a tremendous trial judge who hears the facts and makes the case decision, makes a decision on the case based upon the circumstances and the law. So it is an honor to be here to support her nomination. Again, having said that I had never met Holly before this process began, what I discovered is once that the president nominated her, the number of people in the legal profession, my university professors, particularly at law school, and other judges came to me to tell me what a star, what a outstanding judge Holly Teeter would be. And so my own personal beliefs were confirmed by people who I have great respect for, and I hope you will see that today. And I would ask your expeditious confirmation of Holly after your satisfactory review. This judgeship has been vacant in Kansas for a very long time, and we're anxious to have justice dispensed by Judge Holly Teeter. Mr. Chairman, thank you.
Thank you, Senator Moran. I'm imagining some in-depth conversation about Pearson v. Post and the foxes in connection with that, since you described your first year of law school.
I knew I could capture your imagination and recollection.
Senator.